One of the industry's hottest leading men wants to consult with you concerning research for his next picture. Wow.
Can I help you, sir?
You got a pass for me, Buddy Faro.
Gosh, it's exciting. Never been to a studio before. I bet we'll see a lot of stars.
I've been around show business all my life, kid. It's always very exciting.
Hey, I wonder who it's going to be. Mel Gibson, maybe Harrison Ford, maybe Forrest Gump?
I have no idea who those guys are, but we're supposed to see a movie star. Hey, I wonder if the beautiful and talented Maureen O'Hara is still working on this lot.
Is that a Baywatch babe I'm seeing? Is that a Baywatch babe I'm seeing?
Hey, buddy, what's up, man?
Hey, how are you?
You know that guy?
Nah, there must be a hospital around here somewhere. Hey, you haven't seen Maureen O'Hara around here, have you, Pally?
Boy, I can't wait. I can't wait to meet a movie star. Who's your favorite movie star?
Richard Conte.
Richard Conte.
Yeah, and I always liked Mickey Rooney.
Mickey Rooney, that little tiny guy.
Yes.
Oh, sure, yeah. How about any more recent, contemporary?
Well, that would be Dan Andrews.
Whoa, look at this thing. Look at the size of this trailer. Oh, my gosh, it could fit a whole family in there. It's not even real. It's not even real.
Look at the rock. Look at that. It's funny, isn't it?
Cody Swift. Oh, Buddy Faro. Just a little tiny guy.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong here. It seems to me the real key to detective work is just discipline. You know, shoe leather, covering every angle. Am I right about that?
That's about right.
No, stick with me. It's kind of like chess. You know, it's like putting yourself in the right position at exactly the right moment to make the right move.
Sounds to me he's been reading your book, buddy.
Have you been reading my book?
I'll tell you what, almost all of it. Look, nobody's done a good teenage detective flick in, what, 15 years? The Hardy Boys, forget them. They're phenomenally out of date. The fact is, I want the right stuff on screen, buddy. That's what my audience expects from me, all right? I know you can help me deliver this cheese. Come on, don't say no.
Well,
Cody Swift.
Cody Swift, I think you got yourself a deal, Pally.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, Andre's got Spelling and Warner's in that conference call.
Great, okay, Andre Johnson's my business manager. We're arguing points, ancillary markets, merchandising. Child, I'll see you on the set.
I hate all that stuff.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy, 15 years old.
15-year-old boy stuck in the body of a middle-aged studio executive.
Mm-hmm. Doesn't seem like a bad kid, though.
Yeah, not bad.
What do you think he gets a picture?
The last picture he made, $9.6 million.
Dollars?
Yeah.
Market!
Okay, walk away, all right? Thank you.
Okay, lots of energy now, Cody. Action.
All right, here's the juice, baby. We gotta shake down that snitch Rosenberg.
He's not Dana Andrews.
He's more like Dana Delaney.
Let me get you a nice cocktail dress for this evening, you know what I'm saying, sweetheart?
And reset, let's go again quickly.
He's not getting up.
That was pretty real, wasn't it? A little too real. That guy's really bleeding.
What happened?
Can I see that gun?
Sure.
These are real bullets.
Hey, Bob. Bob, these are real bullets.
What?
Would you like any more cocoa, Cody?
How about a nice peanut butter and jelly sandwich?
I'd be happy to bake some Toll House cookies for you.
Ladies, I'm fine.
Don't move any of your little muscles.
Uh-huh.
It's like she's found the baby Moses or something.
Now, why can't I have that effect on women?
Now, what do you suppose this kid has that you don't have?
Oh, I know what he has. A deathbed scene in his first film, Sunny Side Up, had every woman in the world crying over him.
A real tearjerker, huh? Mm-hmm.
When the video came out, the Surgeon General put a warning on it for diabetics.
No kidding.
Mm. Oh, buddy. If someone's after him, you've just got to help that poor little boy.
to see this movie. Prop man swears he loaded that burp gun with blanks himself.
And the stunt man said that he'd never let it out of his sight. Now, you didn't come to us for research, did you, Cody?
It's obvious someone's trying to hurt you. Hey, look, kid, I don't want to put the muscle on you, but if you don't come clean, we can't help you.
That was great, buddy. I mean, it was just the perfect blend of sincere concern with just a hint of tough guy. I was, love it.
I am being sincere.
Oh, I know. I'm just taking notes from the master, you know. You know, I thought I'd share a bit of the actor's process with you.
Well, let's not do that now, okay?
All right. Look, it was 2 weeks ago, right? We're about to shoot a car chase sequence. They found a leak in the brake fluid hose of the car that I was supposed to drive. Can you believe that? And look, the last few weeks, I'm pretty sure I've been followed.
Give us a description.
There's two of them. In a black limo, there's one big guy with a straight mustache and one little weirdo with long stringy hair.
Now, why do you think these guys are after you?
I don't know. Someone's trying to take my money from me, I think. I really don't understand it all. It's been all very hectic. My business manager can explain it all to you.
Cody called Mr. Faro. He is so relieved that you are working on this. Now, how can I help?
Well, I'd like to start with a little information about what's going on with Cody's money.
His parents were caught overspending his earnings, so the money was put into a court-supervised trust.
You mean his parents were stealing from him?
Not to hear them tell it. They are rude, uneducated people who treated Cody like a meal ticket. That's why he's emancipated.
Which translates to what?
Cody lives on his own. The court removed their supervision as his parents.
But he still has access to his money.
Not until he's 18. The awkward truth is I work for the court. My orders are to protect his money at any cost.
Why would Cody feel that his money is being stolen?
Mr. Faro, in spite of his world-weariness, he is just a child with a ton of power and an ounce of judgment. Among the many things that I have to protect Cody from is himself. Excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Cody.
Oh, how's it going, Bob? We got a surprise for you.
Right. What? What? What do you got?
See?
What is it? Huh? Oh, my God!
Yeah.
I can't believe it! That's my name! Bob Jones!
Why don't you just sit down, okay?
In the chair?
Well, what do you think? Come on.
Go ahead.
Come on. I know.
Cody, thank you. Action!
Okay. Listen, you know what? You need to give someone an order.
Don't do it. No, come on.
Give this guy an order. This guy right here.
Come on. What am I getting? A cup of coffee.
No. Okay, come back here. Two non-fat half-calf latte Supremos, one Maxwell Sparkle salmon and cream cheese pizza, mm-hmm. one Karen Berry Cold Buster smoothie with ginseng right. rum. There, you see how it's done?
Forever, so I suggest you tell that two-bit gumshoe to materialize right now.
Hey, what the hell is going on here?
You Faro?
Yeah, that would be me. Who the hell are you?
Emmett and Stella Cornhaven. This is our daughter, Pamela.
Well, aren't you the cat's meow? Hit the bricks, cowboy.
I believe you've already met our son, Cody. I was a bush pilot, see? Flying bear hunters out to the Kodiak. We're in a lush life, but we didn't want for much. One day, Hollywood comes up to make a dog sled movie. Some big shot, bandy legged Hollywood director catches sight of my boy making faces over his flapjacks. The thing is, I could tell if them shooters were serious the minute they stepped on my float plane. And not one of them Hollywood types knew how to hunt or fish. Or could find his way out of a closet with both hands on the knob.
Would you mind not pointing that thing at me?
So I don't care what he told you, mister. Cody don't need no detective.
Well, somebody is stealing his money, and you two were caught at it once before.
It was a mistake. We didn't understand the law.
So you did steal from him.
That's 2 years ago now.
And only out of ignorance.
And Cody is so big-hearted and generous, he wanted us all to be happy.
Well, it's so nice to know that fairy tales do come
so
true.
Here's the message, Mr. Private Investigator. You mess with my boy, and I'll mess with you.
You know, at first I thought your son might be exaggerating. But now that I've had a chance to look at you and your wife, I know why a kid would want to divorce his parents. back up off my desk.
That is a horrible thing to say.
You're bloodsuckers. And if you ever walk into this office again waving a weapon, you're gonna ride out on it like a pogo stick.
That boy belongs to me, and I'll tend my field however the hell I please. That land is posted. Trespassers will be shot.
Come on, girls.
Studio security issued no passes on the morning of the shooting that they can't account for.
Cody said he was being followed by two guys in a limo. But
limos must get onto the lots all the time. Those security guards aren't exactly FBI.
Well, then let's start with a list of all the studio's limos drivers, shall we?
Man, Cody's old man has a long rap sheet in Alaska. Listen to this. 6 arrests, 3 convictions, simple assault, public drunkenness, grand theft auto.
They are horrible people. But why would anyone want to kill their own child?
Whoever did it knows their way around a movie set. Anybody who's been around pictures knows that you never fire a gun at the target, even with blanks.
Meaning what?
Meaning, if they really wanted to kill Cody, he'd be dead already.
So what are they trying to do, scare him?
Well, that's a good guess. But the real question is why. Cody! Cody! Studio security just told me that the gunfire on the set was not reported to the police.
Well, the police can't know.
Why is that?
Well, because if someone finds out that they're after me, no one's gonna insure me anymore, right? No one's gonna insure me. I'm finished. Right? The police can't know. And besides, what do I need them for, right? I have you guys. Right? Camera's ready for you, Cody. Thanks. Stay close, okay?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks. I just sent him. He's on his way.
Hey, buddy. I got a pizza. I got a latte. Who's that?
Bob Jones, that right? That's Bob Jones!
Hey, get a load of this.
Sir?
Excuse me. I'd like a sparkling water with lemon. I'd like a small salad with croutons, and I'd like some Diet Ranch dressing.
Run.
Yeah, right.
Jeez.
Talk to everybody from the director to the guy in the food truck. Everybody loves this kid.
Well, sure. What else are they going to say? He's the reason they have jobs.
Never met anybody so popular.
Stars operate under a whole different set of rules. As long as he's bringing in Jack, he's king.
Why would anyone want to kill the king?
Very good question.
Another problem is he's supposed to have his birthday at a big club on the strip tonight. It's his 16th birthday.
No. Not in public, he's not. I'll tell you what. Let's have it at the club. This way, we're in control. What do you say?
Good idea.
Sorry.
All right, explain this to me again.
What?
Which one of these guys is handsome?
They all are. They're brothers.
Are you telling me that these are the same Hanson brothers that were in Slapshot?
Oh, no. They'd be too old. Maybe these are their sons, huh?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
What's up?
Happy birthday, baby.
Thank you very much.
I just closed a 3-picture deal with Fox.
That's great. Guess what? I got director approval on my next picture.
Director approval?
That I did.
I'm directing.
Oh, good for you, man.
Brought you a present. Thank you very much.
Just take it. It's like my security in a way.
Oh, those are Cubans, you know, straight from Havana.
Yeah, don't worry. Don't stress, man. We got a party going.
I'm too old for this.
Do you know that these kids could buy and sell us 10 times over?
If we were for sale. You think they know the difference between real life and the movies?
You think they're actually kids?
Who are you?
I go by El Jefe.
It's a nice outfit. What are you, some kind of detective or something?
I classify myself as a rugged individualist. As a result, I don't find trendy adolescent cynicism particularly fresh or amusing.
Cigar down. Put that cigar down. It's illegal. It's gonna stunt your growth.
I got three words for you. Michael, Jay, and Fox. All right, now chill.
Yeah, well, I got three words for you. I am allergic. Now chill.
Upstairs, call a doctor.
Okay.
Come on, Heffy. Let's find out what's going on.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, Julie. Any word on the kid yet?
Buddy and the doctor are still in with him. That poor little boy, he looks so fragile.
Luckily, he wasn't exposed to any toxic fumes or gas. It was just plain old movie smoke. What kind of stunt was that to pull?
Dr. Lovejoy, this is Bob Jones.
Hi.
How's Cody?
He suffered mild smoke inhalation. A little rest, he'll be good as new.
You okay?
I'm fine.
Can I get you anything?
No, it's cool. I'm cool.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm fine.
It's one hell of a birthday party.
I guess. So, is everybody okay?
Oh, they're fine.
You sure?
Yeah. We told them it was a practical joke gone bad.
Really?
They thought it was real cool. We're gonna keep it out of the gossip columns.
Thanks. You know, it's hard enough making friends in this business. I end up choking them half to death.
So, 16, huh?
Yeah.
That's a big one, huh?
Yeah, that's one of them.
Yeah. Did you get a card from your parents?
You know, I don't want to get a card from them. I don't want to see them. It's just that I can go on for hours.
No explanation necessary. They came into my office the other day.
They did?
Yeah.
I'm really sorry.
No, you don't have to apologize either. I just think your father has a bit of a attitude problem.
He's a drinker. But before the movies, he used to yell a lot. And then he used to hit a lot. You know, he'd go after my mom. And just, yeah, I just really didn't like that. When I started getting in between them, he would come after me.
It's no wonder you want it out. Hey, Bob tells me that the guy that brought in the package, he fits the description of it.
What a lousy night.
Yeah. He's beat.
What a great night. Bob,
Your bed is incredibly comfortable. Oh,
you're welcome.
You know, totally starving. What time is it?
It's 10:30. Your car's waiting downstairs. We have to be in the set in 2 hours.
Oh, this is perfect. I know exactly where to go for lunch. It's,
Cody.
Hi.
Here's some special tea that I made for you. Oh. Helps clear up respiratory problems. Are you feeling better?
You know what? I'm feeling a lot better. Really
you
got
can to keep the cup. And I made some more cookies. They're in this reusable tin, which you can also keep.
You know what, Greg? You're an angel. Brenda, right?
Velma.
Oh, same thing. You're an angel. Words can't express. Gotta go. Bye.
Oh, Bob Jones, don't you take your eyes off our Cody.
Oh, I won't. I'm fine, by the way. A little crick in my neck. Oh.